Hi, and welcome to Downtown Alive. This is the program on BCTV of the Downtown Improvement District, otherwise known as DID, D-I-D. And the Reading Downtown Improvement District is focused on creating a vital, productive, and commercially active environment in downtown Reading. DID provides cleaning, security, and marketing services for a specially designated commercial district in the city, and also sponsors several events and activities throughout the year, many of which you will hear about tonight. These include midday cafes, the Reading Holiday Parade, the Reading Fire and Ice Fest, and so much more. DID continually strives to make downtown Reading a cleaner, safer, and more inviting place to live, work, and visit. And don't forget, you can learn more about DID on our website at downtownreading.com, okay? All right. My name is Jack Molets. I'm the host, and tonight our guest is the executive director of the Downtown Improvement District, Chuck Broad. Hi, Chuck. How are you?
Hi, Jack. I'm fine. How are you?
I am excited because tonight, for a lot of reasons, the holidays are just almost upon us, hence the red, and you know, everything has been spectacular this year in downtown. A lot has happened, especially, and I think for the folks out there, as they start to look at this, what we're going to be showing them tonight, they'll realize how much has actually taken place downtown.
Yeah, even for those of us who produce these events during the year, it's amazing when you sit down and actually tally it up and look at the number of events and all that's been done, and you, it really strikes you as it's been a very busy year.
Well, what we're going to do is we're going to talk and we're going to show you a little bit about what went on in 2016 to bring you up to speed, too. And we're going to start to talk about the beginnings of 2017 because there's a lot of great stuff coming up in 2017. And I think the best place to start is the first event of 2016, which will also be the first event of 2017.
Correct.
And that, of course, is the Reading Fire and Ice Fest, which is coming up Friday and Saturday, January 13th and 14th, right?
That's correct. This is our third year producing Fire and Ice, thanks to our gracious sponsors, the Myrtle and Holy Queer Fund at the Community Foundation. So, yeah, this is our third year, and it's going to be a two-day event again, as usual. Additional information from what we say tonight is available on the specific website for that at readingfireandicefest.com.
Great. Now there's a lot of things, and if you were there last year or the year before, I was not there the year before, so I'm just assuming it was as good as last year. It was spectacular. I mean, there's ice, and there's fire.
There's fire,
which is hence fire and ice. But it was funny because when I went there, I thought, well, I understand what ice is, and there's ice carvings and ice this and that and the next thing. But I really wasn't sure about the fire and what the fire was really going to amount to. They're going to burn something down. But what it was people performing with flame, with fire,
right.
And it was exciting. It was a great event. And I got to tell you, the thing that got me and continues to get me is that it's January,
right.
And you're outside on Penn Square, and there's lots of people there, and you're having a good time, and there's food trucks and all that other stuff going on. It was a great event last year. And I suspect it'll be even better this year.
Yeah, see, that primary goal was to do something in January when there usually aren't many organized things for people to do outdoors. I mean, there's plenty of things you can go to, shows indoors. But we wanted an outdoor festival. And you came last year and saw some fire performers. If you'd have been there the first year, the fire element of Fire and Ice, we were a little light on that.
A little light. Well,
the chili cook-off was as far as we could stretch to the fire element.
Oh, okay.
But we were very fortunate last year to find two different performing troupes that actually performed with fire, and they'll be making a return performance for us this year. So when you see somebody actually twirling fire or spitting fire, it's really spectacular.
It was entertaining.
Yeah.
Trust me. I don't know why you would, but I think you should.
Well, you think
trust me, it was really good.
We have a photo here.
If you look at these photos, yeah. Yeah, they were, this was entertaining. And this was right on Penn Street, just below 6th. They were performing, and it was fun. By the time they performed, of course, it was dark out.
Mm-hmm.
Which
by design,
kind of have to make some impact, but it was spectacular, and we'll have more this year.
free and open to the public. We'll have more. We have the same performers coming back, but with some extended performances. We learned something from that performance last year. Because of the fire, they couldn't perform on the stage where the bands performed.
Right.
There was some concern about the fire element, so they performed down on the street. And that didn't work out so well. So we're going to raise them up. They'll be on a platform so that they're above the crowd and the people standing in the back and watch. Because there were a lot of people gathered around watching them perform, and people couldn't see over some people's heads. So we need to elevate them, and that we'll be doing that this year.
We mentioned, and I think you said, that there last year were live music performances, and there were many of them all Friday evening from 5 to 10, and then Sunday from noon to 10. It's just constant music on the stage. And that's going to happen again this year.
Happening again this year. Almost all the music acts for both days are completely booked. We're waiting to sign some contracts before we release the names of the performers. But again, from 5 to 10 on Friday and all day Saturday from noon to 10, there'll be outdoor music, free outdoor music.
It is exciting. And the groups were, many of them were groups, some were individuals. All the music was good. It was fun to listen to.
Mm-hmm.
So, now, as far as the ice is concerned, so that's the entertainment, that's the fire. Now, the ice, I know there are ice sculptures, right?
Yes, there are pre-sculpted pieces of ice along the sidewalks the entire time. We have sponsors that pay for those pieces of ice, and they're what we would call static ice displays. But then we have interactive ice pieces, and what you see on the screen right now is an ice slide, and we'll be repeating the ice slide again this year. And the kids love going up the steps and sliding down this ice slide and coming to rest at the bottom. And their parents even join in going down the ice slide.
So people love the ice slide.
It's
neat. I got to admit. And what's not to love? Yeah.
And then coming back again this year will be a throne, maybe not exactly like the throne you see. Our ice sculptors always do something a little different every year, but we provide, again, a great photo opportunity for somebody to sit on the ice throne and get their pictures taken. Mm-hmm. So we'll have a number of other pieces of what we call interactive ice that you can actually get on the ice or have your picture taken with the ice.
Yeah, that's because there are pieces of ice all around of Penn Square or the 500 block, and this is in the 500 block of Penn Street, and it makes it feel like it's
an outdoor ice gallery.
That's
it's
what
an
it
art
is.
Gallery
yeah.
is what it is. Yeah, it really is. Yeah,
all you got to do is hope it doesn't get too warm.
Yeah, we bordered on that last year.
Yeah,
we had a lot of melting going on. Later. It was great for the crowd, not so great for the ice last year.
Yeah, but as I recall, a week later was the 30 inches of snow.
We were happy we didn't hit that. Absolutely, absolutely.
Now, in addition to displaying ice sculptures, there are some ice carving that takes place at certain times.
There's two types of ice carving that we have at the festival. One is ice carvers are out there, and they just demonstrate how they carve pieces of ice on four different corners. We have four artists going at a time carving. And then on Saturday, we actually enter into a competition. These ice carvers will compete against each other for prize money. And that's fun to watch because they have to come up with an idea and within 3 20-minute segments carve the plain block of ice into a piece of art. We can show some of that. Let me just get to that. There's a live ice carving from last year, a photo of one of the ice carvers sculpting a phoenix. And actually, he added some color to that when it was finished.
That
was a really magnificent piece. So to take a chainsaw, an electric chainsaw, and a block of ice or blocks of ice, and turn it into a piece of art, it's phenomenal.
That's talent. I couldn't do it. But I'm sure these folks started with something simple when they began, and then just built from there. But it is impressive.
And this is what sets our Ice Fest apart from some of the others in the region, that we have this live ice carving that goes on. It isn't just looking at static pieces of ice.
Yeah. That's what makes it nice. But also down there are food trucks, so people can get some food. You don't have to starve while you're walking around.
Food trucks, and we also have our local restaurants that are on the square or close by that people can enjoy. We always promote the restaurants that are open. And we will have a tent again this year and have a wine bar in the tent with wine.
Oh, that's right. The wine bar in the tent. That was exciting, too.
Absolutely. Wine tasting and selling wine.
Yeah. So there's just a lot going on. You really got to get there, folks. Yeah. If you weren't there last year, you really need to be this year. But there are a few other things that we have to mention. One starts on Saturday. Saturday has a number of things going on. And it starts in the morning at 8 o'clock with the Genesius Theater Pancake Breakfast at the Outside In Restaurant from 8 to 10. Right. For anybody who doesn't know, the Outside In Restaurant is on the second floor in the building at 6th and Penn Streets. Right. And they have a pancake breakfast.
This is a fundraiser for Genesius, people from Genesius, the performers there, actually will wait tables and take your order and wait tables. And throw in some musical entertainment while you're having your pancake breakfast. So it's a really neat event that ties nicely into our Fire and Ice. It's kind of a pre-Fire and Ice event. Ends at 10, and then we start music at noon.
At noon, mm-hmm. Right. Now, there's something new going on this year that did not happen last year, and this is for runners.
That's right.
People who run.
People who run. There's not away from anything, but just run for the sake of running.
It's the Fire and Ice 5K and 1 mile fun run, right?
That's right. We were approached by the great people at Core Fitness who wanted to put on a run in conjunction with Fire and Ice. And so they're organizing the run. Probably we'll be leaving from WAC and going along Riverfront Drive, so we don't have to worry about any street traffic. Mm-hmm. And then their award ceremony will actually be up at Fire and Ice at 6th and Penn on the main stage right after the run is over. And after the main 5K run, there's a fun run for children and, of course, if their parents want to go with them. So we'll put both of those activities together down along WAC and Riverfront Drive. Mm-hmm. But the award ceremony for that will be up at about 11:45 before the music starts.
That starts at 10 a.m.
10 a.m. Registration starts at 8:30 for the run, but the race itself begins at 10.
People don't have to register ahead of time.
They don't, but if you register ahead of time, and we'll have information on the website, they get a T-shirt with their registration. Ooh. With the logo on.
See, that's exciting.
So if you register the day of, we can't guarantee there'll be any T-shirts available for you.
Okay, then from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. is the Chili Cook-Off. Now, that's happened other years.
Yes.
And that's going to happen again this year, but this time it's at the Doubletree Hotel.
Correct.
And it's a Chili Cook-Off.
Chili Cook-Off.
You bring your recipe and make the chili and competition. And who judges?
We have a panel of judges, plus we have voting by the general public. So you come in and for a $5 fee, you'll get a strip of tickets, and then you put those tickets in baskets at the vendor spot to vote for whether you believe that's the best chili or not. So there's a People's Choice Award, and there's a Judge's Choice for second and third place.
Great. So the Chili Cook-Off, and that's part of the fire.
That's part of the fire.
The chili.
Chili.
Okay. Then, of course, as we mentioned, the ice carving competition is from 2 to 4 in the afternoon. And then we have the Snowfall Ball.
That's correct.
And that starts at 6 o'clock, goes till 10 p.m. at the Doubletree Hotel.
Right.
And music is by the Swing Fever Dance Band.
Great. That's right.
And now, this again is a repeat that happened last year.
This is the third year for the Snowfall Ball. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Last year it was Eric Koala and the Uptown Band performed, and this year we have a Swing Fever Dance Band.
So it'll be another exciting event. So, I mean, you think about that, you think about the pancake breakfast up through the Snowfall Ball, and the fun run, and the chili cook-off, and the ice carving, and the ice sculpture displays, and the fire performers, and the music all day.
Yep.
It's just, what an event.
It's true.
It's a great event.
If you don't want to go to these indoor events, the outdoor event's still going on at the same time. The free music's outdoors, and the ice is outdoors. And,
right.
You know, you don't have to go to these indoor events.
Right, and so if you don't want to go to the Snowfall Ball, but you still want to hear music between 6 and 10, there are bands playing and individuals, artists playing outside.
Snowfall Ball, you get the opportunity to sit inside at a round table with your friends and enjoy a beverage and some food indoors and listen to great music and enjoy the camaraderie of everyone else who's come out to enjoy the ball.
Yeah. So again, that's Fire and Ice Festival Downtown Improvement District, Friday, January 13th, 5 to 10 p.m., Saturday, January 14th, noon to 10 p.m., with a few things that start earlier. And so it's going to be another fine time in the cold weather.
Yeah.
It's great. It's just great seeing people outside in downtown Reading in the middle of winter.
Well, the first year we were below freezing in temperatures. I mean, the first Friday night we were below 20 degrees. And there were people dancing in the middle of the street at 5th and Penn. So that was very
That's kind of cool. Okay, so Fire and Ice. And again, the website for Fire and Ice is
ReadingFireAndIceFest.com.
Okay. And of course, there's also information at the downtownreading.com, Improvement District website. So that's great. Now, Fire and Ice kicks off the year, and I know last year, 2016, was a really successful year. There were lots of things going on. In addition to Fire and Ice, you had over the summer in the nice months, mm-hmm. you had the midday cafes. Those were 2-hour events every other week during the summer, right?
Correct.
And there were 8 of them.
I believe. They kick off on the first Friday of June to coincide with the World War II weekend out at the airport. And so that's a very special midday cafe for us because the reenactors from the airport actually descend on Penn Square and have a mock battle, World War II battle in Penn Square with the mm-hmm. Allies coming in and taking the town back from the Germans, and then we had the Ringgold Band playing some period music and patriotic music for that event. And then it goes every other week after that on a Wednesday. The first one's a Friday, only to coincide with the event at the airport.
Right, the rest are on Wednesdays. Yeah. And that's downtown. Then you have the Downtown Alive Outdoor Concerts, funded by the Berks County Community Foundation and the Berks County Convention Center Authority. Those have turned out to be very popular.
They have, and this will be the third year for that in 2017. The first year we did 3, this year we did 5, and we'll be doing 5 again in 2017. Mm-hmm. So 5 concerts, all again free outdoor concert entertainment with food trucks and everything that goes with it. We have a misting tent if you want to cool off in the hot summer months. And, so it's
we don't have that for Fire and Ice.
No, we don't have that for Fire and Ice.
Well, that's a good idea. Now, last year, I don't know what the plan is for next year. Maybe you haven't gotten that far. But last year, there were 4 concerts, which were basically at 6th and Penn and people in the 500 block of Penn Street to watch it. And then the 5th one was in conjunction with the opening of the Royals hockey season. The same day.
Correct.
It was up at the Santander Arena.
We probably will be doing 5 in the 500 block and 1 up at the arena this year. The goal is to have 5 events in the 500 block. That's right. The focal point for downtown.
Sure. But it also is nice to have that event
Absolutely.
In conjunction with the Royals
yep.
because it's Royals are another part of downtown and that.
Right.
Just having them around has been a great thing for the city.
Oh, and I should mention, we forgot in my information on Fire and Ice, the arena is doing a Fire and Ice related event. They're having ice racing at the arena.
They are?
Yes, I don't know if it's motorcycle racing, but there's indoor racing on the ice at the arena during Fire and Ice on Friday night.
That could be fun.
Yeah.
So and certainly it would be interesting, but again, as you say, that will be included in the information that you can find on the
website.
And that's
a ticketed event. It's an arena event, right. But it's part of Fire and Ice, yes.
Okay. Yeah. Let's see, what else? What else happened? That was it, right? Nothing else. Oh, no, there was more.
No.
There was the Scarecrow Contest.
Right. Second year for that.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. And we had about 24 Scarecrows that were made. I have some, if I can get to it here. There's 5 of the scarecrows that were put up. So community groups and businesses made a scarecrow, and we put them up in the 500 block of Penn Street again. And they were judged by a panel of judges, and there was a first, second, and third place winners awarded. So it's interesting to see what people produce in putting them together.
Okay.
Well, it exposes our kids downtown that maybe aren't related to the farm show or anything like that. It has no idea what goes on the farm to give them an idea of of hay and corn stalks and scarecrows.
Right. And it's good to bring the farm to the city.
It is.
Now, we also had something called Pumpkin Palooza with funding from the Berks County Community Foundation.
First year for that this year. We had a husband and wife, Sue and Dave Shalong, who brought this idea to us. They had visited their family up in Massachusetts and saw a pumpkin festival and said, we need to do that in Reading, and came to us with the idea and produced the first one this year. I think it was very successful. Weather was terrific. Gave out a lot of little pumpkins that kids decorated there and had, again, free entertainment and music and food trucks and a great event that we'll repeat again in 2017 and probably expand on to make it better. We even took hay bales at 5th and Penn and made kind of a hay bale maze for kids to walk through. And we had horse-drawn wagon rides for people for free.
But they love that.
They did love that.
Well, yeah, they always do. Horse-drawn wagon rides.
Yeah.
Always popular.
In downtown Reading, though.
In downtown
Not
Reading.
Farm, but
you don't see them in downtown Reading often.
No.
Now, we've gotten up to October. Now, in November, of course, two really big things happened, and they're kind of related. First was the holiday tree lighting.
Right.
And then came the, there's some photos. And then, that was on a Friday evening?
Friday evening.
Right.
Friday the 18th, and the parade was the next day on the 19th, yes.
Okay. And that was the new tree that
That's
we talked about
tree.
In our
That's
last
correct.
Program,
correct.
Right? So it looks beautiful.
Yep.
I've been by it. I hope everyone else will. Makes downtown shine.
Very bright. That's right. It makes it shine, and in the daytime it shines because of all the ornaments that are on it for a change.
Yeah. Now, the next day was the annual Christmas parade.
Correct.
Santa Claus, I believe, came today. Yeah, there he is.
By fire truck
by
this
fire
year.
By fire truck. Well, that's a good thing. He's there, and we're all happy to see that. Now, all of these events that have occurred in 2016 will be coming up again in 2017.
That's correct. Yes.
Okay, great. Anything?
And there may even be one or two new things that come along in 2017.
And I'm sure, just like fire and ice, there will be new elements to some of the old things.
Correct. That's correct. We're always looking to improve and make things better, make them a bigger event and something that even more people can enjoy.
Yeah, which is great because, as I said before, Fire and Ice drew a certain number of people the first year. It drew more people the second year.
Right.
And you probably are going to figure it's going to draw more people the third year. Well, the same thing will happen with the other
correct.
Events, too.
Yeah.
So as they get bigger and better, it'll bring more people. So if you're thinking about it, and if you've heard about these things, come on into downtown and enjoy them. But just to recap quickly, the Fire and Ice, the Reading Fire and Ice Fest, and that'll be January 13th, 5 to 10 p.m., Saturday, January 14th, noon to 10 p.m., live music, ice carving, a whole bunch of stuff, all the stuff we talked about. And so it's going to be a great kickoff to a great year in downtown Reading.
Absolutely.
Terrific. Well, with that, I thank you for being
thank
here
you,
and
Jack.
Filling us in. And I say to all you folks out there, have yourselves a wonderful holiday season. Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, Happy Kwanzaa, Happy New Year, Happy whatever you celebrate. And in 2017, come on downtown and enjoy some great events, okay? And we'll see you next month here on Downtown Alive.